The next presentation is OP53. It's on echocardiographic evaluation of anthracycline-induced cardiotoxicity in breast cancer patients from southern Sri Lanka.
Thank you, madam. Good afternoon, y'all. Topic of my study is echocardiographic evaluation of anthracycline-induced cardiotoxicity in breast cancer patients from southern Sri Lanka. Anthracyclines are commonly used to treat wide variety of solid organ tumors and hematologic malignancies. However, the clinical utility of anthracycline is hampered due to various side effects. The most common one is the cardiotoxicity. Free radical induced oxidative stress is the main reason for cardiotoxicity, and it can be divided as acute, subacute, and chronic cardiotoxicity. Transthoracic echocardiography is a reliable method to investigate cardiotoxicity, and estimation of ejection fraction provides early sign of cardiac dysfunction. Objective of this study was to determine the prevalence of anthracycline-induced cardiotoxicity using echocardiographic findings. This is the methodology. Study was conducted at the Oncology Unit Teaching Hospital, Karapitiya. All newly diagnosed breast cancer patients administered with anthracycline cyclophosphamide were enrolled in the study. These exclusion criteria were considered when recruiting patients for the study. An interviewer administered questionnaire, BHT, and investigation reports were used to collect data. 196 patients were recruited to the study, and records of echocardiography were obtained at these four occasions: 1 day prior to chemotherapy, 1 day after the first dose of chemotherapy, 1 day after the last dose of chemotherapy, and 6 months after the completion of anthracycline chemotherapy. These parameters were recorded from the echocardiography. Subclinical cardiac dysfunction was defined as fall of ejection fraction more than 10% from the baseline value. These are the results. Mean age of patients was more than 53 years and BMI was 24.2. Mean cumulative dose of anthracycline was more than 340 milligrams. There was 32.7% of patients with Nottingham grade 3 cancer, and doxorubicin was the most commonly prescribed anthracycline, and most of the patients were given 4 cycles. Docetaxel was the second most common second line drugs, and there was 7.1% HER2 positive patients. There were more than 42% of patients with diabetes mellitus and more than 35% with dyslipidemia. This shows the comparison of echocardiographic parameters at 4 stages. There was no significant difference between 1 day prior to anthracycline chemotherapy and 1 day after the first dose of chemotherapy. There were significant differences between 1 day after the last dose of chemotherapy and 6 months after the completion of chemotherapy. Various risk factors were identified in the study, and use of cyclophosphamide was the most common one. There were 65 patients out of 196 with the reduction of EF value more than 10%, and this equation was developed to predict the EF value 6 months after the completion of chemotherapy based on the value of day after the last dose of chemotherapy, as the follow-up echocardiography is not practicing in our clinical setup. Equation developed will be useful in monitoring and early identification of asymptomatic cardiac dysfunction. Some risk factors couldn't be excluded from the study, as this was conducted as a prospective cohort study. According to this study, it is recommended to carry out long-term follow-up to detect early-onset chronic progressive cardiotoxicity in patients receiving anthracycline chemotherapy. Thank you.
Open for discussion now.
The data from other countries?
When consider the other Asian countries, the subclinical cardiotoxicity is not this much higher. It's about 20% or less than 20% like that. But in our country, it is 33%.
Was it because there was a large number of diabetic patients who might be having already existing cardiomyopathy subclinical? Did you look at whether there is a significant difference between those with diabetes and those without diabetes?
Actually, I did that one, but I didn't include it in this one because...
Was there a difference or there wasn't a difference?
No.
There was
no, there are any difference.
Thank you. Please give a round of applause to her.